everyone, welcome back to the Steel Donut. My name is Matt, and with me today I have Bob.
This is my final intro line.
Connor.
Hello there.
Blake.
Hey, everyone.
And Yellow.
Good day.
And we are back with ChIIpmonkth. We are back with one sick chipmunk.
And I believe this is the final video of ChIIpmonkth.
It is. Yeah, this is. It's got the last part in it. Wow, I'll be darned.
Whew. Dang. So almost over.
I can't believe we made it all the way through.
A sad day for all.
A sad day for all monks and monkettes out there.
Oh,
who are clad.
All of them are clad in all their colors.
All clad. All right. So here we are covering chapter, 7, 8, and 9, correct?
The final chapters.
Yes.
Nope. The final chapters of One Sick Chipmunk. Chipmunk!
One Sick Chipmunk, part of ChIIpmonkth.
It has been One Sick Chipmunk.
All right. So starting with the author's note of chapter 7. Here is the next chapter, and this one will have some very strong language and scenes of brutal fighting.
Oh man, is Tareen's gonna kill somebody?
Is he gonna punch somebody's knee backwards again?
This is why this was rated fiction T.
Yeah. Dave charged at Ian. He had his fists clenched and eyes narrowed. Ian stepped out of the way to let his men take care of Dave.
Well, there we go.
Yeah, I didn't know that's how you did
that.
Double
that, I guess.
Out of the way. Pretty boy this coming through.
Dave couldn't stop himself in time and ran straight into Ian's men.
Someone stop me, guys. Someone stop me.
Oh, shit.
Hold me back. Hold me back.
Him. No, please do.
Please hold me back. I don't want to get murdered.
Yeah. Too fast.
Teach him a lesson, boys.
Dave was screwed.
Him, boys.
Yeah, fuck him.
He's screwed. He's
wow, the narrator just doesn't have any faith in Dave.
I don't either. You.
I mean fair,
look what they are about to do to him.
Oh no. Ian's men garbed Dave and started to punch, kick, and stomp on him.
Dave will be clad.
He'll
red,
be clad
his
in blood. Nice.
Hey, he's gonna be turned into a fucking Persian rug. They're stomping on him.
Yeah.
He's getting.
Oh man, they're just flattening
stomped.
Him out.
You know what I like about garbed him is even if that R was in the right spot, he still would have spelled grabbed wrong.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
Still would have spelled it wrong. There was no saving that one.
Damn. Simon, Jeanette, Theodore, and Eleanor watched on in horror as their guardian and dad was being beat by these jerks.
Sounds like these two different people there.
These jerks.
These twits.
These jerks.
Hey, Connor, he did warn for some very strong language, okay? You should have expected that.
Yeah.
Right.
This is pretty brutal, too. So.
This is pretty brutal.
He is just getting stomped out. What the hell?
I'm watching on in horror as well.
As the beating continued, Simon decided enough was enough. He started to walk towards the fight.
Very slowly. He's a little chipmunk.
Why, Simon?
Inside that nerd Demeter was a secret, courageous, muscular warrior.
He's like a martial artist.
It's not that.
Guy.
It's just that the others don't think that enough is enough yet. They think that he should get beaten a little bit more.
Yeah, they're waiting for him to get beat up a
little
bit more.
Simon thinks, like, okay, he's had enough, guys. Let's let him up. Simon,
give him, like, another... like another couple seconds at least.
Give him like another
five stomps. Turn this around. I think he has them right where he wants them. They're going to stomp on him so hard their feet will break, and then he'll get them.
Yeah.
As Simon starts walking towards him, do you think he starts singing, "I'm not afraid
to take the stand"?
That would be in character.
We'll see.
Yeah.
He was about 8 feet away when a paw touched his shoulder. Simon turned around to see Jeanette looking like she was about to faint.
Has she followed him over there?
8 feet away is like fucking like a really
very far.
Like he's got a ways to go before he can.
Yeah, but they
do
move
anything.
So, they move
I mean,
so quick,
is he ever
you know,
going
scamper.
To be able to do anything?
I mean, ineffectually, maybe.
We don't have
but,
the hyperbolic time chamber this time.
I mean, he'll be able to do something. Whether or not it's effective is a different question.
Yeah,
that's true.
Right.
Simon grabbed her by the waist just in time to catch her. Eleanor was starting to tear up. Theodore was close to screaming.
I'm hungry!
And here's a great line. Here's a great line.
Then out of nowhere...
Hey period. Guys, do you see any whirs?
Nope.
No,
there's no whirs. They're all gone.
Yeah.
Wild. Wait, no, there's one right there. I see it.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Hey, my turn.
Ian's men and the four chipmunks turned around to see the one person they thought had run away. He would never run away.
Why would he run away? He's the only one equipped to handle this.
He is the strongest, the ultimate person.
The other four did not know he was there. He's only interacted with Alvin so far.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That is That's actually true.
No, they thought he'd run away out of their lives forever.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they thought he ran away to, like, another state.
Yeah, like he ran away, you know, like, from them altogether out of their life. Mm. But no, here he is.
Yeah. Instead, he ran in from a different story.
Oh, shit.
Universe.
Yeah.
Right, so here he comes. They've called in their striker.
Therese!
All four chipmunks yelled in unison. Ian frowned and looked at his men. Ian nodded his head toward Therese. The men ran at Therese at full speed.
Oh my god, they're gonna fucking Naruto run him down.
Oh no.
Full speed ahead, boys.
They couldn't stop themselves in time and ran straight into Therese.
Can I just say, these last few sentences feel like they should have been part of a bulleted list?
It's a storyboard.
Like, Ian frowned, looked at his men. Ian nodded his head. The men ran. Like,
you know, maybe what happened was they had, like, an outline, and it was a bulleted list, and they were like, God, I don't know. Fuck it. And they just backspaced each of the bullets and put tighten it up into a paragraph, and they're like,
there we go.
Good enough. Done. Whatever.
But Terrence, it's 5-1. Then it is a fair fight.
Yeah.
Finally, a fair fight.
Yeah.
Terrence got in his fighting stance, ready to tear these bastards apart. Oh. As Ian's men got closer, Terrence bent down and readied his fists. As Terrence got ready, a song started to play in the club that was just right for this kind of situation.
All right, now to play the exact sort of song you'd hear in the club. Yeah. An acoustic cover of Headstrong by Trap by the Steel Donut Collective.
Circling, you're circling your head, contemplating everything you've ever said. Now I see the truth I got down, a different motive in your eyes, and now I'm out. I'll see you later. I see your fantasy. You wanna make it a reality paved in gold. See inside of our heads, yeah. Well, now that's over. I see your motives inside, your decision to hide. Hey, back off, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong. Headstrong, we're headstrong. Back off, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong, and this is not where you belong. Impressions got to be your very best. I see you're full of shit, and that's alright. That's how you play, I guess you get through every night. We'll see you later. I see your fantasy. You wanna make it a reality paved in gold. See inside of our heads, yeah. Well, now that's over. I see your motives inside, your decision to hide. Yeah, back off, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong. Headstrong, we're headstrong. Back off, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong, and this is not where you belong. Can't give everything away. give everything away.
Finally reach Terrence and start to throw punches at him from every direction. Terrence ducked and dodged every one of their punches. Then he threw a few of his own, connecting with two of the men.
Are his punches hitting multiple dudes?
He's like Rayman. He throws his fist and it hits multiple right people and comes back.
Or that, or it's just like a beat 'em up where if you have a crowd of people, you can throw
people stacked
a combo.
Up on each other.
People
you punch.
Stacked up. Yeah, true. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. One of the men went behind Terrence to try and grab him by his neck and choke him out. Simon saw this and yelled...
the sentence ends with that. So.
Oh, right. And yelled...
Also, I'm trying to think of a good metaphor for how he describes fights, and I really can't.
Terrence, behind you! Of course behind him, he had people punching him from all directions.
Yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah. He looked and saw the man. He whipped around and caught the guy off guard. Terrence winked at him, then crack! Terrence hit him with an uppercut.
Why did he winked?
I'm gonna fuck you up, but first I'm gonna...
I'm gonna be playful about it.
Because I'm that cool of a guy.
Yeah. Hee hee, what a fun fight.
Hope you guys are having as much fun as I am.
Yippee. Oh, no.
No hard feeling, folks.
The man fell back out cold. Terrence turned back towards the remaining men and motioned for them to bring it on.
Okay.
The men charged at him again. Terrence was ready and waiting for the right moment to strike. When the man in front of the rest came close enough, Terrence jumped up and roundhouse kicked him in the head, knocking the man off of his feet. The other men stopped and watched as their comrade fell to the ground, holding his head in agony.
I like how... Like, it sounded like... He had to motion the others to come closer, so it sounded like when the one guy grabbed, or was gonna grab Terrence, the rest of them backed off. Like, way backed off.
Yeah,
and then they run forward a bit. One guy runs forward more, gets his ass kicked. The others, stop and back off again.
I mean, you're basically describing the way the Batman Arkham fighting system works, right? Like, you hear, and then, two dudes walk up, and then, blue things appear over their head, Terrence takes them out, and then, the other guys are just waiting in the background, and then they come up in a group of three, or two, or one, and, everybody waits their turn to attack,
Yeah, it's one of those.
Yeah. Just one of those days.
Oh, wait. Wait, what?
Terrence looked at the remaining three
Who's
men.
That? What?
I don't know. Who's
Terrence?
That?
Who the hell is
Terrence?
Terrence?
Who the fuck is Terrence? Where did he come from? Why is he looking at the three remaining men?
Well, he's just some guy who was passing by.
I guess he was in the club, right? He was just in the club here to. He was here to. They were playing his favorite song, "Headstrong" by Trapped.
Uh-huh.
Right. Yeah.
Terrence looks at the remaining three men. Who says this? Either Ian or Terrence.
It's Terrence.
Okay, so do your Terrence voice, Blake.
Sure. Well, are you just gonna stand there, or are we going to finish what you started?
Terrence is such a regular guy. Yeah. Such a nice guy.
What a totally normal human.
Ordinary, perfectly ordinary human.
The sort of person they interview for like the local news.
Yeah.
What exactly. What do you think of the new Hardee's that just opened up?
I can't believe they opened one up here. They had another one in town a couple years ago and they had to shut it down and they like cut it down to just like, oh wow, geez.
Yeah, exactly.
Just your regular everyman.
Yeah.
Ian was getting extremely pissed off now and yelled for his men to attack.
Men attack.
Terrence smiled and said out loud,
"And here comes round three, ding, ding, ding."
He's really having a ball with it, huh?
Yeah, he is actually enjoying himself so much. Good for him. Terrence waited for the three men to make their move, but nothing happened?
What?
Like nothing happened.
Oh, there. Here's a twist. Then, out of the blue...
Oh man, is Max Vincent here?
I guess.
Yeah, I guess so. All the Chipmunk stories are colliding.
Up increase the collision. I can do the Max Vincent voice. Everyone freeze. This is the police. Get down on your knees and put your hands behind your heads now.
I was really hoping that would rhyme because, like, everyone freeze. This is the police. Get down on your knees. Put your hands behind your.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have used the old pronunciation. Put your hands behind you heeds now.
There we go. Yeah.
That works.
Open the door. Get on the floor.
Everyone walk the dinosaur.
Yeah.
Terrence, Dave, Simon, Jeanette, Eleanor, Theodore, Ian, and the three men did as the officers told them to.
Oh, okay. Alrighty.
Dave tried to reason with them, saying that his sons, and their girlfriends were here to try to rescue Alvin.
I'm amazed Dave is even alive.
Wasn't he being stomped out? Like, how is he still conscious?
I gotta say, there's, like, first of all, it's still savage that they put sons in quotes. Like,
that keeps happening.
Apostrophes that were supposed to be quotes.
Like, single quotes, some apostrophes. Two pieces of punctuation are more decimating than the stomps of those four men. But also...
murdered by words.
But also, what do you mean Dave tried to reason with them? They're cops. They're not, like, wolves. Like, you can reason with them.
You're not supposed to wait for them to cuff everyone and then you explain. You don't just get up and say, "Hey guys, I just want to let you know we're innocent. They're the guilty ones. All right, glad we cleared that up. I'm gonna go." Like, no, that's not how it fucking works.
That's all true.
Right, cops, I'm about to head out.
Yeah, if the police ever try to arrest you, just get up and say, "Hey, I'm innocent," and they'll just let you go.
That's worked for me in the past.
I mean, Blake, have you seen any of Live PD?
I have, actually.
People do some weird stuff.
I imagine Terrence probably just walks up and says, "Officer, I watched the whole thing. Let me tell you what happened."
Yeah, I'm a witness, let me tell you.
Okay, well, let me get my notepad.
I think I left it in my other coat.
Could you imagine Max Vincent in L.A. Noir?
And then,
like, imagine L.A. Noir, but Max Vincent was the protagonist.
You don't even get the doubt button. You're just going, okay.
As much of a sad sack as he is, though, the thing is with Max Vincent is that he's also really awesome. So, like, he would be like, "Oh, I forgot my pen and my notepad." And then one of the bad guys would spring up and he would just immediately shoot the gun out of his hand.
Yeah, it would be like a weird, like, L.A. Noir, but you don't get the doubt button. Instead, you get the, like, pathetic line button. But then when a gunfight starts, it's like Bayonetta. Like, you're like, firing, you're doing sweet tricks and flips and shit.
Beautiful character action video.
I just really want to hear Max Vincent go, "Do you fuck young boys, Valdez?"
All right, well, here, well, you know what, I'm gonna give you a wish. Christmas is coming early for Matt. Do you fuck young boys, whatever name Matt just said?
Valdez.
I'm sorry I couldn't remember your name. I should have looked closer at the information sheet.
Oh, you should have looked at my notes. Oh.
There you go, Matt.
It appears I was mistaken.
The officer in charge looked at everyone lying on the ground. That's when he noticed that there were two chipmunks lying on the ground unconscious. The officer recognized them immediately.
Is that Alvin, Seville, and Brittany of the Chipmunks and the Chipettes?
I don't know who the rest of these chipmunks are. I've never seen them before.
Yeah.
But before anyone could respond to his question, Ian jumped up and pulled out a pistol.
No!
Oh,
Ian,
no!
No! You bastard!
Doreen saw the gun and bolted up faster than the police could react.
Oh, shit.
Ian saw him charge and pulled the trigger. Bang! Everyone froze.
Oh, fuck.
The police pointed their weapons and fired. 8 shots were fired.
8 then shots?
Ian fell to the ground, dead.
Jesus! They lit that motherfucker up!
Yeah. Damn. I mean, that's what you do.
I know, they lit him up. Yeah. Guys, did Terence just...
Terence took the bullet.
Did Ian just die?
He's fine.
Terence is fine. Terence is fine, right? Like, Terence is
right,
fine.
Like, it bounced off his muscular attacks.
He has to be fine. He has to be.
He's Terence.
As the police officers covered Ian up, the other 4 chipmunks and Dave looked toward where Terence was lying on the ground face down.
Not a single person went over to Terence. He got shot and he's lying on the ground.
Are you fucking
laughing?
And their
first response is to go cover up Ian.
Terence is dead and that is laughing.
No. Terence is just goofing on him, right?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
He's just goofing. Yeah, it's a goof.
He'll just stand up and be like, psych, gotcha.
Yeah, Terence is just goofing. That's why none of the officers went over to him.
Yeah, because they know that he's fine.
Yeah.
He's gotta be, right?
Dave, Simon, Theodore, Jeanette, and Eleanor walked over to Terence. He wasn't moving or breathing.
Well, he's really in the goof, huh?
Fuck.
Simon yelled for one of the officers to help their friend. The officer in charge radioed for an ambulance to their location.
He wasn't gonna do that before!
3 minuets passed and the ambulance arrived. The medics got out and started to give aid to Reens.
Yeah, but he doesn't need it because
he's waited
fine.
For them
but
to tell him.
Fine. The grammar's getting worse, but
because he's
just
crying
too worried about
Terence
to goof on that.
Yeah, but who needs to be worried because he's okay. He's okay.
He's okay.
As the medics worked on, Terence, Simon, Theodore, Jeanette, and Eleanor walked over to their unconscious siblings. Simon knelt down beside Alvin and started to sob.
Oh, it's Alvin. Who gives a shit?
Yeah.
Oh.
Come on, Alvin. Wake up, bro. Please link up for me and Theo. We need you. Alvin, please.
Come
Don't
on,
wake
Alvin,
up for yourself.
Up,
you exist
please
to serve
wake up
us,
for
Alvin.
Me and Theo. Yeah. What is with the rhymes?
Yeah. I don't know.
They're chipmunks. They're performers. They rhyme even when they don't mean to.
Yeah, they're singers and songwriters.
With the medics, they continued to work on Terence. They kept trying to revive him by shocking him with the paddles.
That's not how that works, but okay.
That's not to...
No wonder
God.
They're having trouble if that's what they're doing. they're having trouble because he's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. When that didn't do anything, they used adrenaline to try to restart his heart.
Man, it's crazy how he can just stop his heart like that. Like
yeah,
a good,
just, he's
like
a really fucking JoJo
good.
Character.
You know, I've heard that there's monks that can meditate and slow their heart rate to 3 beats per minute, so maybe, like, he's super powerful, so maybe he could do it, like, 3 beats a year.
He's, like, 0 beats per minute.
He's just using his stand, you know,
yeah, I was
to,
gonna
to
say,
stop
he's
his
using
heart
his
temporarily.
Stand to stop his heart so that Dio doesn't
right,
notice
Terence,
him. That's a good goof, man. You don't have to keep it up,
just
though.
Just come on, man.
I don't know if this is really the best time for us to be goofing.
But nothing worked. So they declared him DOA, dead on Aravel.
Oh, this is supposed to be sad. Fuck you, Chipmunks for Life 101. Yeah. I was trying to have an emotional moment for 2 seconds and you ruined
Chipmunks
it.
Chipmunks for Life 101. You have got to.
You
spell your words correctly, man.
You fucked it up.
If you're
also,
gonna
I was about
even
if he's
moments.
Sad and you made me laugh,
I'm sorry,
you piece
even
of
if,
shit. Even if he had spelled it right, it's like this character that we know and love and who sacrificed himself for the chipmunks. And they just go, so they declared him DOA. Can you have like a fucking, like a moment of decency?
Yeah.
Oh, like, you're just like, God. They tried shocking him, they tried adrenaline, he's dead.
They tried shocking him.
Yeah, but life is just a series of tragedies, you know?
This is truly the biggest tragedy of all.
You know, they say comedy is tragedy plus time, and it's about 2:15 where I am, so that's a time.
Yeah.
I'd say this is comedy now.
Well, they also say that comedy equals tragedy plus misspellings.
Yeah.
That's true.
I would believe that one.
So yeah, throw F's. I feel like we're gonna have the fucking premiere chat on the side. Yeah, just go ahead and throw your F's in the chat for Terence right now. He's right. Dead.
He's dead.
What a way for Chipmunk to end, by the way.
Damn.
We still got
two more chapters after this.
Major character death.
I mean, Terence is gone, but we don't know if Alvin and Brittany are.
Yeah, but who gives a
shit about them?
Yeah, fuck them. Right. I hope they're dead.
No, man, I love
that. That took direction.
All right.
I love them chipmunks.
With the chipmunks, Simon has stopped trying to wake up his brother.
Good.
Oh, Theodore was crying on Eleanor's shoulder. Wow, that's a full
interesting
quote,
yeah.
Eleanor
instead
quotes.
Of him. While Jeanette was crying on Simon's. But what they didn't notice was that both Alvin and Brittany were starting to wake up. Simon was looking away when he heard a real faint moan.
My head is killing me.
Oh.
Simon looked back to where Alvin was laying. His eyes went as wide as silver dollars.
Cha-ching! Life
Simon,
insurance.
You get to do it this time. Even though Dave is here.
Alvin!
Why?
Theodore.
This is not the time. Terence just died.
No, but... Don't you get it? It's a thing that you know, in Alvin and the Chip, it's funny because it's a reference to a thing they do. It's hilarious. So, you can put it anywhere.
Has anyone else noticed Terence is dead? Because they don't seem to be noticing that.
No, I don't think they've noticed yet.
Okay, I don't think they've noticed yet that he has been declared dead on Aravel.
Dead on Aravel sounds like the name of a fantasy game.
Yeah, it really does. It absolutely does.
Theodore whipped around and saw that Alvin was indeed awake.
Alvin.
That's not like an exclamation point.
Just sounded like you were in slow motion.
Yeah. You're awake.
Both the chipmunks hugged their brother with tears of joy running down their furry faces.
Furry confirmed.
Furry fucking faces.
Furry confirmed.
I mean, they are chipmunks. They are chipmunks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Jeanette and Eldor smiled at the scene in front of them. But before they could join the reunion...
Hey, where's my hug, huh?
They both turned around and saw that Brittany was standing and looking at them both. Jeanette ran to her sister, followed closely by Eleanor.
Brittany! Oh, thank God you're all right!
They tackled her to the ground.
Whoa! Hey, now be careful with me, you two!
Make
don't
her
damage the goods.
Fucking old lady.
As the six chipmunks reunited back with their siblings, Dave was told the news about Terence.
Oh, here's where
the
we find out.
Six chipmunks reunited
tip.
With their siblings.
You know.
Yeah.
They have
four
six
chipmunks
other siblings.
Reunited.
Yeah.
With
so you see, the author back there was totally playing a prank on us. He actually is alive, right?
Yeah, he's been revived. Yeah.
The news about Terence is that he's really good at pranks.
The officer in charge walked up to Dave.
Mr. Seville, I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but...
He took a deep breath and exhaled slowly.
Okay. Okay. No, alright. Any day
like,
now.
Okay.
You can tell me awkward. Whenever you want, I guess.
Your friend has passed away. I'm really sorry for your loss.
Passed away. Yeah, he got shot peacefully in his sleep. Like, what? Yeah. Passed away? Fucking
yeah,
shot.
Passed away. Oh my god. Dave couldn't believe what he was told. He knew that he had to tell his sons
god,
and their girlfriends.
Stop doing that!
That's ow. More brutal than what happened to Terence!
Stop that!
What
stop
are you
doing?
Doing?
Can you please, for the love of God, stop
just
doing that?
Like, what?
Yeah.
He walked over to them and kneeled down. All six looked up at him. Their faces went from happy to worried.
Dave, what's wrong? Where's Terence? We have to tell him that Alvin and Brittany are awake.
You all saw him get shot. Like, they're just like us. They just assumed
he'd be
fine.
They weren't paying attention.
No, they just assumed that he would catch it between his pecs and just flip it back at the guy.
Yeah.
He'd be
yeah.
like fucking Raditz
which
or some
bounce,
shit.
Which bounce off his chest as if he's Superman.
Oh, no.
Theodore noticed a tear was rolling down his dad's cheek.
Why?
Why?
He never mentions in any other story.
Okay. Chipmunks for life.
First
stop,
of all,
please.
Fuck you. But also, like, the punctuation here is really, like,
don't you like how the S
quote,
is like,
open quote, apostrophe S apostrophe?
No, what happened is that was supposed to be a quote, but the S got stuck between it.
In between
the two apostrophes, yeah.
Someone get that poor S out of there.
I know, he's stuck, please. God, trapped. Someone help him. He's trapped there.
Dave, where is Terence? Please tell us.
Dave looked them straight in their faces and said,
Terence has passed away, guys.
Dave lost it and started to cry really hard.
Really hard.
And the others froze at what Dave just told them.
I think
them.
I'm about to lose it.
I really like they started to cry really hard. As, yeah. Like, for real, guys, it was so hard. He was crying like, yeah.
Really
so hard. Yeah, there you go.
He was like a father figure to me.
Yeah, he's crying, but it sounds like
he was like
passing a
father
kidney stone.
Figure to me.
He was like a father figure to me because he definitely wasn't my dad, you know, or
yeah.
Anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. My father figure. Yeah.
What do you mean he passed away? He was shot.
Yeah, yeah. That's very different. Asked Theodore with a confused expression on his
he
little
face. He was
shot
peacefully in his sleep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. He went to sleep right before Ian
oh,
pulled that pistol.
I'm sorry. This is even stupider than that. Theodore doesn't know what death is.
Simon put a paw on his baby brother's shoulder.
It wow. Means that our friend Terence is dead. Theodore.
Oh, no, he knows what death is. He just doesn't know what passed away means. He's never heard that expression.
Oh.
Because when they say Terence is dead, he's like, oh, that's what passed away means. I thought you meant he left. Like, he got in his car and drove off.
He passed into another state. Away into another state.
Yeah,
a state of no longer living.
He passed away to France.
He moved to France. That's where he went.
Yeah, there you go. At hearing that, Theodore broke down in tears. Dave grabbed all six of them and hugged them tight.
Not hard.
But not too tight.
After all, they are just his kids.
I was wondering, thank you, author.
No, I thought he crushed them or something. Nothing. Glad you got that cleared up.
We were about to make so many jokes about him squeezing their insides out or something.
Cut us off at the pass.
Dang.
Bucket, guys, we
that's
lost again.
That's a zone of protection right
guys,
there.
Guys, we got gotten, guys. Chipmunks for Life 101 got one over on us, boys. Mm.
That's what I'm saying. We
pack
lost
it up,
again.
Boys. We
pack
lost again.
We lost another one.
God damn it.
It's over.
After they said their goodbyes to their best friend, they all went home to rest and so that Alvin could take his medication.
Bye.
They don't even have to go down to the station to give a fucking statement.
Nah, they don't even have to. The cops are like, you guys are probably tired.
Open
get
and shut case. Yeah. Open and shut.
Yeah.
They look at Terence's dead body and just go, bye. And
yeah.
Leave.
That's why I'm like later, bud.
They get back in Dave's car and go home.
It's literally a bye.
Yeah.
Okay. There is that chapter done, but don't worry, there will be an epilogue to finish this story outright. I hoped that Yo enjoyed this chapter, and please review.
Yeah, the epilogue is apparently Alvin's Fight for Life Part 1. That's a hell of an epilogue.
Epilogue is two more chapters.
Yeah, an epilogue that's two more chapters, and the first one of the two epilogue chapters is Alvin's Fight for Life Part 1!
Oh man, he's going to play the game Fight for Life.
So yeah. Gotta keep moving on. Hey, peoples, what's up? I'm back and apologize for the long wait. Anywho, there will be one or two chapters left after this one. Well, enjoy.
What? The one or two left?
You don't even know when your own story ends?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty wild, isn't it?
On the drive home, it was quiet. Alvin and Brittany were laying on each other, sleeping. Claire and Dave didn't say a word to each other. Simon and Jeanette were sleeping on each other, but Jeanette was in Simon's lap.
So how was Simon sleeping on Jeanette if she's in his lap? Was he sandwiched on her?
Yeah, he's like sandwiched over
this on
her.
This is going to be a word puzzle, so you know, at the end they're going to say, like, you know, Alvin and Brittany were laying on each other sleeping, Claire and Dave didn't say a word to each other, Simon and Jeanette were sleeping on each other, but Jeanette was in Simon's lap, Theodore and Eleanor were sleeping next to each other, what is the bus driver's name?
Yeah, exactly. Theodore and Eleanor were sleeping next to each other, Claire looked in the rearview mirror. She smiled at the six chipmunks sleeping on one another.
I gotta say, it actually really does make it seem like a word puzzle that everybody's name starts with a different letter, so you can, like, map it out on a piece of paper with just, like, letters.
Yeah.
A,
B, C, D, like, come on! And then S, J, T.
Dave turned down the street that they live on and then pulled into their driveway.
Huh.
He shut the car off and opened his door.
Wild. Okay, guys, we're home.
Dave looked in the back seat and awed at the sight in front of him.
Terence is dead. Aww.
That's not awed like cute. That's awed like whoa.
Yeah, he's just
when I said awe, I meant awe. A W E.
I like this door that is going to be opened because Claire got out and opened the back passenger side door, reached in and picked up Alvin, Brittany, and the blanket that was covering them.
You really
the back
could
passenger
just,
side door.
It you covered just, all the basics. You,
you could have just line broke and gotten to them inside the house. Like, I do not give a fuck about how they got everybody out. Dave, grab the other four and meet me at the front door. Everyone want the dinosaur.
Yeah, more sweet-ass rhymes.
Dave nodded his head and picked up his other kids and shut the car door. Whoa.
I think you mean his quote-unquote kids, okay?
Kids. There's,
I mean,
there's no quotes.
No, these are his other kids.
His real children.
His actual children.
These are his real kids.
All right, Jeffrey and Sam.
And Adam. And,
two other names.
Yeah.
Come with me. My human children.
My perfectly ordinary human
my
children.
My biologically
yes, human father.
Children.
He walked up the path and stopped at the front door next to Claire.
Okay, let's go in and put these kids to bed. Not one, not three. Why would you put this much detail into something so unnecessary?
I don't know.
It's an epilogue and it might be one or two chapters. Bobby's run out of shit to talk about.
So make it no chapters!
He's
you
run out of shit
to, say.
To write about. He's gotta drag it out
as much
as possible. He's got
Bob,
nothing left.
Bob.
He killed the only character we liked. There's nothing left here anymore.
Bob, it begins as it ends, alright? We
Doldrums.
Got through Chipmunks for Life's cool, awesome action plot.
Uh-huh.
So now he can go back to, like, the family drama story he inherited. Remember
oh,
when he
right.
adopted the story?
Yeah, that was just an interlude.
God, if you read from the beginning of One Sick Chipmunk to this, it, like, from the original story, it must have been, like, it must have been, like, family drama, illness, and then suddenly someone kidnaps them, gets gunned down, a random OC who hasn't showed up yet gets shot, and then back to family drama. Like, what?
You know how most stories have filler arcs? This has the opposite of that. This has an arc with so much incredible, crazy content.
And the rest of it is filler.
You know what? Yeah. I just realized something. We once said in the recording for the Bob the Builder creepypasta, like, who would care if someone killed your OC? Now I understand why someone would care.
Oh, damn. Yeah, we did get an emotional connection to Terence. So.
Go ahead and put more Fs in the chat.
Make sure you post, like, some beer emojis, pour out a cold one for Terence.
No, Terence would never drink beer.
Yeah,
he's straight as flip.
Yep.
Straight edge
straight
flip.
Edge, dude.
Yeah, grab some water cup emojis and pour those out.
Yeah, yeah.
Dave nodded his head for a yes and went in after Claire did.
Dave nodded his head for a yes, like a human.
They put the six chipmunks to bed and shut their door. Dave sighed as he slid down the wall in the hallway.
What? I think they mean he like put his back to the
yeah,
wall
and
then just like
floor.
Let himself fall.
Here it sounds like he just did like a shimmy. Like he's like
sneaking
around.
It makes it seem like he slithered along the wall.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. It makes it seem like he like got up on the wall and slithered down it.
He did like a cool wall ride or something.
Yeah, like a cool ass wall ride.
Or he's like a snake man. Dave, sweetheart, what's the matter? Why aren't you speaking? I'm the only one who's speaking.
Yeah.
You haven't said a word.
Your lips move.
Dave,
I can't
took
hear
like
what you're
four
saying.
Fucking chapters of me sitting silently for me to get some lines and now I've got too many.
Dave looked up at her and she saw that he had tears in his eyes.
I don't know, Terence is fucking dead. Maybe that's why I'm sad.
Well, actually.
Why would you be sad? He's dead.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. No, why would you be sad about that?
Yeah, he's gone now.
He's gone. Why are you sad? He's not here anymore.
There's no reason to be sad anymore. Because he's gone.
Oh.
I just realized that I could have lost my boys in the Chipettes tonight. And also, Terence is dead, but I don't care.
Yeah, Terence is dead, but whatever.
Nobody seems to care.
Claire hugged him closer as he cried on her shoulder.
Stop!
Comedy is tragedy blessed with smellings.
101, stop!
I'm just going to say, instead of when doves cry, when Daves cry.
Dave, listen to me. You are a really good man and a good father to those kids. Just kidding. She doesn't say it like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for you going to look for Alvin, who knows what could have happened?
Yeah, that's because he's a good father to his actual Dave. Kids, the human babies.
Question, what did Dave do?
Dave got beat up. The only person who helped was already there.
No.
Yeah.
Dave did nothing.
Hey, yeah. Terrence was there.
Dave drove the chipmunks over there to watch Dave get beat up. That's, you know, he provided a
Dave
night of entertainment.
Dave left the house, came back home, picked up Claire, left the house Claire. Again, and then they drove around for a little while.
Now, his beating was distracting them long enough for Terrence to come in and save the day.
I guess. Yeah, he was at most a distraction.
I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
Dave looked at Claire and nodded his head. Many asterisks later that night.
Downloading a new line break.
He can get.
God. Alvin was sleeping soundly. He had his paw draped across Brittany's waist.
His huge paw across her whole waist.
Paw wrapped around the trigger of
a gun.
Yeah. See, people, how do people fuck this up in fanfiction so much?
I don't know, but suddenly, Alvin started to cough extremely hard.
Oh, that's right. He's sick, isn't he? Forgot about that.
He is dying. Remember, guys? That's the thing this all started.
I forgot. Oh, yeah. Right, now I remember.
Each time he coughed, he shook the chipette beside him. Brittany jumped up and turned towards her boyfriend.
Stop coughing. God.
God, come on. Stop doing it.
Brittany reached over, grabbed a pillow, reached over to the other side, smothered Alvin with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alvin was coughing so hard that there was blood on the sheet underneath him.
Oh, just seeping out of him.
I don't know whose blood it is, but there was blood there. Yeah. It doesn't say.
Alvin!
Brittany yelled as she saw the monk she loved look up at her. Then seeing his eyes roll to the back of his head.
Oh, they went into his skull.
Yeah, a pair of X's appeared on his eyes, and he went, I am dead.
Yeah, just had to get one more coffee.
Not his eyes rolled back, but rolled to the back of his head. So they just went into his skull. You know, it's just like your eyeballs behind them is a long tunnel that goes right to the back of your skull.
That's horrifying.
And your eyeballs just can roll all the way back in there.
Oh, that's gross.
Matt, I know you did this in the first video for One Sick Chipmunk, but he just looks over and goes, change the world, my final message, goodbye. He coughs one more time. And
then the Windows 98 startup sound happens.
His soul
It's the
disappears.
Windows 98 shutdown sound.
Oh, shutdown sound, you're right, sorry.
No, this time it's the shutdown sound.
Oh, this time it's the Windows 98 shutdown sound.
Yeah.
Dave ran into the bedroom with a look of panic on his face.
What the hell is going on here? What the fuck do you think?
Is Alvin still
sick?
You
know Alvin's ill.
Is Alvin ill?
So Brittany yelling Alvin probably means that he's not doing well.
Alvin? Who's Alvin? Yeah. Is he ill? Is he my son?
Is he one of my children?
Children, quote unquote.
Brittany was on top of Alvin trying to wake him up. Dave ran over to Alvin's bunk and looked at Brittany.
What? Sorry.
Yeah, say the line. You.
Brittany, what happened? And why are you on top of Alvin? Dave, did you just blow in from Stupidville? What do you think is
that's
happening?
That's where he's been all this time.
Wacky comedy?
Wacky comedy, while Alvin is fucking dying again.
Yeah, I just flew in from Cincinnati, and boy, are my arms sore.
Brittany glanced at Dave, then back at her dying boyfriend. Oh. He was now coughing up diamonds.
Yeah. Oh.
He's not breathing. What the fuck do I do, Dave? He's not fucking breathing. You motherfucker.
Oh. Whoa.
Oh.
Whoa.
Eat shit, Dave. Strong fucking language.
But he didn't warn for strong language for this chapter.
Guys, yeah, hang on. He said strong language last chapter, and there wasn't a single bit of language that was strong.
Guys, this isn't an epilogue. This is not how epilogues work.
No, plot is just still going on. Plot's still continuing. Yeah,
I love that classic epilogue at the end of the Deathly Hallows where he defeats Voldemort.
Yeah, that's in the epilogue.
Yeah, that's the epilogue.
Yeah, my favorite epilogue is, you know, Lord of the Rings when they get into the volcano and destroy the ring.
My favorite epilogue is the entirety of Return of the King.
Yeah.
All of it.
I was going to say, my favorite epilogue is when, you know, Gandalf comes and visits Frodo in the Shire.
Yeah, that's my favorite. I mean, like, it's the epilogue to The Hobbit. I don't know if you ever read it. It's called Lord of the Rings.
Dave looked back down at his dying son.
Simon! Oh, shit! Alvin, quit breathing!
Okay, I'm sorry. I haven't updated it forever.
Oh, my God.
I don't care.
Guys,
you think
guys.
Your story could need it more? Like, why didn't you just end it then?
Guys, listen. Okay, here's my theory, though. Because he hasn't updated in so long, like, there's been a long time between, he forgot that he was just gonna end the story, so he just continued it.
Oh, yeah. I hope not.
Yeah, I think that's what happened. Yeah. He forgot that he said he was going to do an epilogue, because he obviously never goes back and, you know, reads his previous chapters. Otherwise, he'd notice the grammar errors.
Also, I like how they decided to wake up Simon.
And he would fix that Terrence earlier.
He would have fixed Terrence earlier, But, like, I just love that they're going to wake up Simon. It's like, oh, he's the smart one, so of course he can respond in a medical emergency. People who are smart are just smart about everything, you know?
Yeah, why are they all freaking out? Like, you know what? They should do what they did last time, which was get Alvin's medication and give him some.
The last time he was coughing, this time he stopped breathing.
Oh, I guess so, yeah.
Who gives a shit? Okay, let him die.
Yeah. They just need slightly stronger medicine.
Yeah.
Please don't hate me. Asterisk crawls in the corner, humming and rocking back and forth.
Space asterisk.
Anywho, please leave a review telling me what you think will happen to Alvin and what you, the readers, would like to happen next. Oh. CFL out.
CFL out.
Canadian Football League.
This became a choose-your-own ending? Right at the end, maybe?
Maybe. I do like that, you know, now there's the mental image of just a guy in a corner, like, being curled up and such. And then I like that he's, like, rocking back and forth.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden his head shoots up and he's like, anywho, please leave a review and blah, blah, blah.
Just imagine the cover of My Own Prison by Creed. And then that, like, guy just pops his head up. It's like, hey.
Sorry, I just had a little manic episode. Anywho, back to, what's it, Chipmunk? So, yeah, one more chapter. Chapter 9, Recovery and Romance.
So not Alvin's Fight for Life Part 2?
So did someone choose this? So did he respond to someone? Did someone choose this ending? Is this an end your own adventure?
We'll see. Well, maybe the reviews for Chapter 8 were like, no, save Alvin or something. So, hey peoples, here is the second to last chapter for this story. I hope you all enjoy it. There will be a song in this one.
Oh my god! Stop!
This is Mongoose Lover levels of forgetting.
Wait, stop!
Wait, I just noticed. He says second to last. State is complete.
Yeah. No! Yeah. The story ends in this chapter. Yeah. What are you waiting for? Ellipsis. 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 Okay, I'm done waiting. So ellipsis, ellipsis, ellipsis. Not one, not three. Period. I said go ahead and read.
Say my name.
Okay, now he's given us permission, so...
Yeah, let's go.
Simon!
Dave yelled as loud as he could.
That's as loud as
Brittany was still on top of Alvin, trying to revive him. Jeanette entered the room first. She froze when she saw her older sister on top of her boyfriend rocking back and forth.
The fuck do you mean Jeanette entered the fucking room? They all sleep in the same room. You said that last chapter.
Stop combining dramatic potential chipmunk death with like fucking, oh, it's not what you think. Also, like, it doesn't work.
And also, fucking remember shit. Just remember. Like, what do you mean she entered the room? They're all together.
Because we're all in this room together.
One world, you know, one tribe. One room.
God damn, that's good. She looked at Dave and then realized something was wrong. About 5 minutes after she entered the room, Simon came running in.
What the fuck was he doing?
Slowly waking up.
Yeah, Brittany is like on top of Alvin trying to reverse cowgirl him back to life.
Oh, man. No.
Oh, I wish that were happening to me.
What's going on in here?
Dave bent down and picked Simon up.
Why is everyone just screaming? Why don't you all know that he's sick? It's in the title of the story.
I believe I quote Ralph the Movie Maker when I say, look how dramatic my fanfic is. Everyone is shouting.
Yeah, basically.
Well, I paraphrase, but...
Yeah.
It's Alvin.
Simon looked at his brother and froze stiff. What he saw made him almost pass out. Dave put Simon on the bed and sat back.
What?
Brittany looked behind
him. Hold on, what is Dave's plan here? He just called Simon in here.
I told you, Simon's smart, therefore anything that requires the smarts, he can solve. You know, medical emergencies, you know. I think...
I'm an adult, but I'm going to call in my smart
son.
Child.
Son.
Son.
But son, yeah.
Or maybe it's just like, he's going to call Simon in first and be like, say goodbye to your brother. And then he's going to call Theodore in next and then go say goodbye to your brother. And then they're all going to bury Alvin in the backyard.
It's like when they're calling out the cast at the end of a play and everyone steps out and takes a bow, except they all step and they press X to pay respects or whatever.
Yeah, it's like, well,
oh my God.
If you want, we can get another one.
Just go to the pet store.
Maybe we can get a different one this time. You know, we've gone through several chipmunks. Maybe we can get a fish.
Yeah. There will never be another Alvin. I know, but maybe this next chipmunk will be just as good.
That's why we're getting the fish.
There'll never be another Alvin, but I don't know why you said that like it's a bad thing.
It might not be a great idea to name him Alvin, too.
It might be important.
You know, we'll just call him Alvin the Squeakle.
Ah, okay.
Ah, perfect. Brittany looked behind her and saw Simon just staring at his unconscious brother.
I told you, it's like a play.
Brittany stopped what she was doing and slapped Simon as hard as she could.
Why? Don't slap. What did he do wrong?
You're not slapping him to get him, like,
she looks at
back
Simon.
Into the, like, not trying to slap him out of his stupor. She's slapping him as hard as she can.
Yeah.
Just, she just wants to knock that fucker out.
Yeah, like Brittany looks at Simon, she's like, slap yourself. And then he doesn't do it, so she's like, well, okay, I guess I'll do it for you.
What the hell? Oh, thank you.
You did that perfect.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Yeah.
Brittany pushed him over to Alvin and pointed.
The narrator's so worried that even he's like, oh my gosh, and he's sick and you need to do something.
Chipmunks for Life is freaking out that he might have accidentally killed off Alvin.
Oh no, I might have killed Alvin. Yeah. What do I do?
After I already killed Tyrion.
Oh, no, I have to write Simon into the scene back. So he can save him.
Right.
Simon, please, save him.
Simon nodded his head and began to work his medical magic.
See?
He's a cleric. Yeah,
he's going to cast heal.
I cast Cure Wounds.
Yeah, Cure
All
Wounds.
All my problems
Actually,
are
before
answered.
I cast Cure Wounds, I'm going to channel Divinity and raise his health back to half and then, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Simon ran up to Alvin and started CPR.
That's some good medical
Matt, you were CPR certified, weren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you can tell us how accurate this is.
Hey, to be fair, that does we know that because Matt is a man of magic.
I'm also CPR certified, but I'm not a man of magic.
I mean, so am I. I just wanted to...
I am too.
I think I'm the only one here who actually...
All right, so Yella, we're the authorities.
I'm going to teach you how to do it, okay, Yella? All right, go ahead and read.
If all five of us are ever hanging out and Yella just drops, the other four of us are just going to be looking at each other like...
He's going
to
do this.
We're all going to race to Yella's body and be elbowing each other. The way. I want to be the one to save him.
Yeah.
No, I want to do the CPR. And of course, the problem is he doesn't need CPR. He's just got a leg cramp. And he's telling us, guys, stop, please.
Right.
Yeah.
Guys, stop. My leg just hurts like hell.
Oh, for the record, those out there in the audience, if you have multiple people who are CPR certified, you usually just do it in shifts so that way no one gets too tired.
Yeah, you just do a, you do two person. Yeah. If you've got... got four people, you can do two sets of two man.
You could also do it like a chain. That's the way they used to do it. That's the way I was trained, where I do CPR on Yella, and then Connor does CPR on me, and then Blake does CPR on Connor, and then Matt does CPR on Blake, you know.
The problem is there's not going to be four of us able to do CPR once, like, Bob German suplexes me, and we both knock ourselves out.
Yeah.
12,345, asterisk, breath, asterisk. 12,345, asterisk, breath, asterisk. 12,345, asterisk, breath, asterisk.
Yella, if you were wondering how CPR works, that's how it works.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Every 12,345 seconds, you give him a breath.
Nice. After the last compression.
Okay.
Cool. Asterisk, cough, 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 asterisk.
The narrator's clearing his throat.
For mood, yeah.
Simon sat up and was breathing heavily. He looked down at his brother,
Simon
hoping
sat
that
up.
He was going to be okay.
Yeah, he was breathing heavily.
Simon, you fucked this up, bro.
Like, he tried the CPR, but then he got so out of breath.
They
he
look
had to
away,
lie
they
down
look back, Simon's
second.
Unconscious too. And it's like, what the shit,
God
Simon?
Damn it, we lost another one.
He looked down at his brother, hoping that he was going to be okay. Brittany slid as she dropped to the side of her now conscious boyfriend.
Wait a minute, she was still fucking him?
Yeah. She was still fucking him.
Alvin barely opened his eyes, trying to make out anything that he knew or could remember.
Do you have any amnesia?
Maybe. Simon leaned down and spoke softly.
Alvin, can you hear me?
Hello, hello, hello. Is there anybody in there?
Alvin nodded. Bud Barley.
Oh,
Bud Barley, what?
Bud Barley.
Yeah,
a classic.
Barley. This barley makes sense. Mm-hmm. There's a classic.
I love that one.
Simon stood up and turned towards Dave and Brittany.
He's going to be okay, but right now he needs his medication.
Doc wants to put me on a
Dave nodded and ran to the living room where Alvin's medication was.
Ah, here it is.
They didn't keep it in his bedroom
with him.
Yeah, where he is.
I remember whenever I was very sick, I always made sure I kept all my medication downstairs as far away from me as I possibly could. So that anytime I needed it, it was a journey and I felt better, you know, that I was able to go get it.
What you do is you keep it far away from you because that's just a crutch and you should get better on your own.
Exactly. And it gives you a sense of accomplishment once you've gotten your pills.
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's why I did it. So I mean, feel
when
good
I was a kid,
my parents
never did that. You know, when I was a kid, like, I'd get sick and then, like, I'd be laying in bed. And what they would do is they'd open up the pill bottle and just toss all the pills on the floor. And so, I'd have to, like, look around my room for it. But it still wasn't as much of an adventure as if they had just left it downstairs.
Now, if they had done that downstairs, I think that would have been more fun and exciting,
definitely would have made me get better a lot faster.
Yeah, yeah. Connor had that crippling bee allergy, and every time he got stung, they would have to drive to the bank to get his EpiPen out of the safe deposit box.
Yep, exactly.
that's a real adventure.
What an adventure, though, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Dread.
You do it for the vine.
Potential danger.
Yeah,
you do it for the vine. Dave grabbed his son's medication and ran back up the stairs. He entered the bedroom, tossing Simon the pill bottle. He's tossing this whole pill bottle to this tiny animal.
The pill bottle's the size of Simon.
No.
Yeah.
Dude, no. Technically...
Well, okay, maybe Simon's a little bigger, but, like...
Yeah.
It's, like, half the size of Simon.
Yeah.
I
like that he's finally accepted that Alvin is his son. Yeah.
It's a good development in the story. Like, that's progress.
Let's see if he changes his mind again.
Simon opened the bottle and gave Alvin the pill.
Imagine a chipmunk opening a pill bottle. Just think about a chipmunk opening a child safety pill bottle.
Dude, he's like twisting it like he's trying to like break open a vault or something.
How's he gonna get fucking like leverage to like even?
Like he throws his whole body on there. Like he grabs it.
Yeah. How's
like,
he gonna twist it then?
Yeah, well he grabs his legs around it for grip, and then he grabs it with his arms and goes.
Brittany holding on to the other end.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Yeah. Thanks, Dave. You could have opened that for me.
Alvin popped the pill into his mouth and swallowed it. Simon backed up and stood next to Brittany. Alvin laid there and slowly sat up.
No.
Brittany moved to help him. She grabbed him by his arms and lifted as he pushed with his hind paws.
What?
Simon walked over to him and looked him over.
Oh.
Alvin sighed as he tried to balance himself. Alvin stood by himself and was able to stand with no help.
Oh, whoa, he's
fast
fine.
Acting medicine, yeah.
It just took a fucking miracle tonic.
Why didn't they just give this to him earlier?
Yeah, like 15 seconds ago he was dead and now he's fine.
Good medication.
Yeah.
Brittany smiled as she took his paw into hers.
Oh,
Simon nodded his head, then left.
Bye.
Dave sighed as well and also left the room.
Bye.
Yeah.
After everyone was gone,
I have fulfilled my purpose in this scene.
I'm not even going to check on you to make sure you're okay. Not a single word needs to be spoken.
And Theodore slept quietly through the night.
Yeah. Oh my god. Yeah, Theodore wasn't involved in this at all.
Theodore, Eleanor, and Claire all just slept through the night on that night.
Yeah, you look at the script and it says stage direction. Everyone leaves the room one by one. Dave turns around before leaving. Dave, : All right, Alvin, I'm about to head out. End.
After everyone was gone and the door was shut, Brittany kissed Alvin passionately on his lips.
The taste of blood, I love it.
Oh.
Alvin was shocked at first, but then relaxed into the kiss.
Huh.
Why is he shocked? Like, they did this before.
Actually, you know, I feel like I've read this before. Have we read this before?
You read it in every chipmunk
familiar.
Story.
Yeah. It's almost like Gilly knows
chipmunk
how to write.
Story.
It's almost like Gilly knows how
to... They all have Alvin surprised to be kissed by Brittany.
It's almost
why
like...
is it always a shock?
His pink clad counterpart.
In Alvin's defense, he was dead like 20 seconds ago. So
he's still adjusting to
this
life.
This is going very fast.
Yeah, but this happens every time in any situation, regardless of context.
No, right. It was hours ago. Do you remember how long those counts were between the breaths?
Thousands of seconds. After several minutes of making out, Alvin broke the kiss for
minutes. Oh my god. This happens in every story.
It happens in every story in any fandom. In any fandom, whenever someone makes out, several minutes of making out broke the kiss for air. Also, this is how you kiss. You take a deep breath, you press your lips together, and you just hold it. And then you back out and you breathe.
Right.
There's no chances to breathe during the kissing.
There's also no enjoyment to be had.
Yeah, apparently. Brittany looked him in his hazel eyes. Alvin winked at her as he moved his paw to her backside.
Oh.
He rested his paw on her right buttock. Then he squeezed it.
Oh,
it was just ringed by like some fucking 80-year-old man. All of a sudden, he moved his paw to her backside on her buttock. Yeah, sexy language. Oh.
Oh, no, wait. I'm so close. Come on, give me one more.
I'm so fucking close.
Brittany widened her eyes. Then her eyes formed into a glare.
There it is.
Oh,
Wait, I'm so close.
Alvin Seville, you are one sick chipmunk.
Oh! The title drop is exactly what I needed.
Oh, fuck.
The title
case
is exactly what I needed.
Yeah.
Oh, God, it's everywhere. Oh, fuck, I can't stop. Someone help. Oh,
my God. Laptop is full of cum.
Oh, God. Oh, man. Oh, it's like, No, really. I can't.
He just keeps going.
It keeps going.
This is normal for you. Calm down.
I guess this is just the life I live now, huh? This is just going to keep doing this, huh?
Tamale.
Tamale.
This is where we are, huh? This is where we're at right now. This is what we're doing.
Alvin smiled and kissed her to the bed and laid her
kissed
on her back.
To the bed.
Weren't they on the bed?
Where are we?
No, they were floating.
They
were suspended in space.
They're on the bed on the blood-soaked sheets.
Yeah.
No.
Oh my god, you're right.
So,
man.
Alvin smirked and broke the kiss.
You better believe it, baby. And you, my beautiful Brittany, are one sick chipette.
That's not the title.
That sucked. I fucking hated that.
Also, is he just better now? Like, is he just cured?
Miracle pill and he's fine.
But he had these pills before.
Nah. See, they had to get him close to death for them to work.
Yeah, that's just how
And then, how do you end this dramatic, beautiful story?
Yeah.
God,
the scene fades as the credits start scrolling and the ending song starts playing.
And we get a wonderful
Simple Plan
song.
Save you.
Take a breath. I pull myself together just another step until I reach the door. Sometimes I wish I could save you, and there's so many things that I want you to know. I won't give up till it's over. If it takes you forever, I want you to know. When I hear your voice, it's drowning in the whispers. You're just scared. Left to take, no matter what I do, I can't make you feel better. If only I could find the answer to help me understand. Sometimes I wish I could save you, and there's so to pull through.
Wasn't that just adorable?
No.
No.
Well, not really.
How'd this make your final how'd this make your final draft? This isn't a final draft. Why are you reading it to me?
Well, this was the last and final chapter, despite what I said at the start of this chapter.
Oh my god.
I hope and pray that you all enjoyed this continuation of One Sick Chipmunk.
You better fucking pray. Prayer to the only god you know that is the only way anyone would possibly enjoy this.
And I, Connor of the Steel Donut, hope and pray that you all enjoyed this continuation of Chipmunk, which was ChIIpmonkth.
Nice.
Yeah. And then I'd like to thank all my... Yeah, we're just going to skip all these fucking names.
Yeah, there's a whole list of people.
Because I believe we're going to see this...
fucking patrons on Patreon.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. These are all the patrons who supported me. Yeah, but once again, you just read through, and it's just like, again, the hive mind. Chipmunk Fanatic 80, Alvin NASCAR 5, Alvin Seville 101.
I'm certain we will see... We will see these people in the reviews, which we'll cover after this.
Right.
A little bit more, so let's finish the author's note. And a very special thank you to Scarlet Moons. Thank you so much for letting me continue and finish this story for you. It was an honor.
Oof.
Anywho, thanks again, and to all the other guest reviewers, thank you for your support. CFL 101 out.
Boom.
I like just to imagine, like, Scarlet Moons reading this and being like, well, that's definitely not where I was going to take any of this.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah. She just... Wow, CFL. Also, you really fucked it, didn't you?
Dead. Hey guys, yeah, Tariq is just fucking
dead.
I wish that he's just gone. Step back from that ledge, my friend.
That's pretty sad.
They did not care that Tariq died. Like, no one cared. Left the scene.
You know, I was thinking maybe the reviewers would care more. If I jump to the reviews for Chapter 7, one review mentions Tariq, and it's just how sad about Tariq. Keep up the good work.
Oh my god.
But yeah, so let's start from the back.
Yeah.
And I guess Vegeta 12345. Oh yeah, the Saiyan Prince is the first to review. Nah, just kidding about the Saiyan Prince part. Anyway, awesome story so far. Keep it up,
Al
and Brit and Chipmunks for life. Keep it up, fictional characters.
Yeah, but remember they're always showing up in the author's note. Remember, and it's just like,
oh yeah,
Al and Brit are going to tell you the story
once. He does that like once. And then just drops it, luckily.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Okay, says, Scarlet Moon's the original writer.
Yeah, she comes in.
Yeah.
I think it's great so far. I posted a final farewell note on the original story. I told everyone that if they wanted to continue to read the story, that it would be here. Again, I want you to know how thankful I am that you took over. It gave me a lot more time to work on some of my other stories. You rock. Anyways, Scarlet Moons. Oh, that's a bad sign off.
Oh, my God.
Scarlet Moon.
With what she said here, I'm just afraid that she's actually going to be very positive about all of this.
Yeah, I have a feeling she will be. Clutter, I do want to say, Clutter Lover up here, guest review. I love this story. I've been a little sad for the past 2 days because my mom had to change me from schools on Friday, so I won't get to see all my friends anymore. So it's good to have something to get my mind off of, probably never seeing my friends. Jeez. For a while, maybe. Anyway, great story. Keep writing, smiley face.
Jesus!
Whoa. That's some tonal whiplash. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, whatever.
Good. I really like this review here from Mr. Buck the Weasel 6 where, on Chapter 2 where he says,
in typical Chipmunks for Life fashion.
Yeah, put a space in the middle of it.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Just, mwah.
Kingsman, right above that.
Uh-huh.
Is it Justin Bieber? No.
What?
I wish... Is it Charlene? No. I mean, there's a ton of, you know, errors.
Just go, man.
Whatever. That'd be awesome, though. Chick fight. Well, I don't know who it is. What it's Ian isn't it, period. You left a pretty big clue who it was, man, but great to continue story so far.
Did he have a fucking stroke writing that? I had a fucking stroke reading that.
He's like, it's Ian, isn't it? You left a pretty big clue. And I'm like, I think that was the idea. Like, you make it sound like that was a problem.
Yeah, it looks like all the reviews here think that it was supposed to be like a fucking hinted, mystery story. Who could it be? Like, no.
Yeah. Can I just say, Can I just say, that last sentence, like most of this review, just makes me think, why they call it an oven when you up in the cold food, mm-hmm. up out hot, eat the food. Like,
absolutely.
Just... Yeah, that meme is going to continue forever just because Yale is so good at reciting it.
Yeah.
I love it too much, I'm sorry.
But yeah, Scarlet Moons,
I'm not actually sorry.
I find this really funny. I'm getting over a cold myself. Anyways, great chapter. I'm so very thankful to you, you know? You know? Anyways, yeah. It's Ian, right? Why am I asking this? I'm a blonde, so don't ask questions, lol. Then why is your DeviantArt picture of yourself have red hair?
I mean, that could be a picture of anybody.
No, that's absolutely supposed to be her.
Yeah. On chapter 4, Pedo Bear wrote, as a guest, what do you mean, will Ian get them? If Terrence can beat up Ryan and other morons, he can beat up Ian. Then again, I bet Ryan wasn't even a challenge XD.
Jeez. Ryan wasn't a challenge.
I love that we're not the only ones who follow the exploits of Terrence.
I'm sorry, yeah. Terrence? I think you
but
mean
these
Terrence.
These people think his name is Terrence. We know the truth. Like, Alvin Seville here thinks, oh shit, run, Terrence, run. Who's Terrence? You don't know who Terrence is. Terrence doesn't appear.
I'm with Tomcat549. Great chapter, run, Alvin and Terrence. Run.
Mm-hmm. No,
you got it right, yeah. Tomcat. Dude. You're reading the details.
Yeah.
What the He's fuck? Reading the story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. These people are like, really? We're thinking Alvin was going to die. It's like Mariposa Prime says, poor Alvin. He's not going to make it out of there.
Why would he die? He's Alvin. I love that, like, Scarlet Moons has already given up on reading the story.
Yeah,
before we started reading reviews, we decided we were going to read all her reviews, and she wrote, like, two, and then went, like, oh, what did I do?
Yeah, I mean, there's one final, like, one on chapter 3 where she's just like, great chapter, and that's it.
Oof.
After that, she just stopped.
But... In her defense, I don't have anything else to say about it either.
I'm on page 2. So, you know, let's keep this kind of structured.
C4C, up near the top of the page, says, don't stop breathing! Alvin, live! Live, I tell you!
Whoa! What happened there?
Lilv! Amazing chapter. Update very soon, fools.
Well, Alvin Seville 101 at the bottom of page 2. Just kick his ass! I just like that.
Whoa. Bite!
Yeah.
Well, actually, I want to draw attention to two reviews. Guest on chapter 1 said, man, Scarlet Moons, why you had to delete the original part 1 of the chapters and have him leave part 2? At least lend him your original part before deleting your stuff. Like, if you wanted to continue this, at least lend him your original before getting rid of your story from the very beginning. Now all we got is chapter 8 over, not the first 7 of the beginning. Come on! Seriously? Which is like, you had like, you... said the same thing like 6 different times. Well, but also, I love Sage the Gemini 157 saying, and this is, I think, maybe the most honest thank you I've ever seen. Thanks for putting me in the list of people who reviewed.
Wow. So I really was kind of close to my prediction that of the 65 reviews, it would basically be, you divide that by 9, and it would be like the same 7 or so people reviewing every chapter.
Pretty much.
Not as much as some of his other stories, but
pretty sizable chunk, yeah.
And let's make sure that the reviews don't increase in number, right? Eh, yeah, people don't review.
Yeah, I've skimmed through all of them. I think I have a good review to end in one from chapter 9, the final chapter.
Keep in mind, this is ending Chipmunk.
Yeah, ending Chipmunk. Well, in that case, I feel like we need. I don't know if any of these reviews could really do that, but I like when this guy said. I love it. You need to make more in stories like this.
No, I think I know the perfect way to end Chipmunk. Is by finally admitting that Theodore was getting the best head.
Absolutely, Theodore.
It was Theodore. He was getting the best head. Everyone else, get the fuck out. Get the fuck out. I don't want to hear about it.
If you think Alvin or Simon was
like, get the fuck out. He can unsubscribe. Fucking unsubscribe.
You dumb pieces of shit. Because Theo was getting the best.
Who even says Simon's doing it? No one says Simon. Because Simon's not getting the best head.
Simon might as well not be getting head.
He's not even. Dick might not even. He's probably even out.
She's probably just sewing up a tear in his pants. He doesn't wear pants.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Rest in peace, Terrence.
Rest in peace.
You will be missed.
Rest in peace, Chipmunk.
Damn.
Rest in peace, Chipmunk.
Rest in peace, Chipmunk.
Rest in peace, Theodore.
You got the best hat.
Thanks for watching.
And special thanks to our supporters on Patreon. Their names are on screen now. If you want to contribute but don't want to join the Patreon, we have our PayPal linked below as well. Regardless of your level of support, feel free to leave your thoughts or requests in the comments or in the public Discord server. All relevant links are in the description. Have a good one, and thanks again for watching.